Okay, guys, welcome on the call to everyone. It's good to see a few different names on the call, and no matter what part you are in the world, welcome. My own name is Paul McCarthy, and I'm privileged to be on the call today here with Pierre Stanley, the owner of Traffic Powerline. A lot of you on the call would know myself. Just an introduction of myself. I've been working online 8 years. And I had the privilege to be involved in some very good companies, and I also have been on the wrong side of some companies who let me down. But I've learned as I went on through the years, and right now I'm involved in some very good companies, and it's a great time to be working online. Over the years, I'm after getting to meet some fantastic people, and what we do before we decide to get involved in any company, we don't decide on our own. We get together and we go through everything. We make sure a few different people have different strengths. I've seen different aspects of the business. So we study the business before we go to our team or anything. So Chris on the call, Chris Cronin, introduced me to a company that Pierce owns a few months ago. Personally, I didn't do much with the company because I was focused on what I was doing myself. I took a position to support Chris because Chris would follow me into a few programs. But I never recommended anybody, nothing about the company, just that I was focused on what I was doing. And then Chris contacted me recently and said, listen, you need to get on a call with Pierce. I need to show you what's happening. And myself and my business partner, Matthias Guzda, went on the call. And after we listened to Pierce, what Pierce is going to roll out to you today, we really said we cannot miss this opportunity. It's too big. Everybody always complains about one thing in multi-level marketing. They can't get any spillover. Well, guys, take some notes because everybody in this gets spillover because it's just one line. I'm not going to take Pierce's thunder away, but I'm going to hand it over to Pierce. Pierce is going to do the presentation. As I say, it's recorded, and after the call, send me a message and I'll send you the recording. With that, Pierce, I hand it over to you and thanks.
Thanks very much. Great to be here. It's a great opportunity. It's a unique concept, and I'm not going to talk too much. We're just going to get into it because, as Paul said, it took quite some time to go through it the first time. And we've tried to reduce the presentation now so that it doesn't take as long to go through. Very interesting concept. So let's just get to it, okay? Now, I've been involved in revenue share for a while now, and I have a company that's a revenue share program. But the revenue share industry isn't, the easiest industry in the world to work in, especially from an admin point of view. It can be an uphill struggle. So we decided that we needed to do something to make a much, much more powerful, much, much more sustainable model that had some of the aspects of the revenue share industry, but not them all. And I wanted to design a platform that would reward the leaders more. Okay, one of the things that annoyed me about the revenue share industry was the team builders, the leaders, they all earned the same as the people who were passive. Passive people, everybody earned the same, and it just didn't sit well with me at all. The other thing that didn't sit well with me at all about revenue shares is their, potential unsustainability. Okay, that annoyed me as well, so I wanted to address that. The other thing that annoyed me about revenue share programs was their lack of external advertising. That kind of contributed to their, they're not considered to be as legitimate if they don't have external advertising. And mainly what annoyed me was their longevity. Okay, so I sat down one night and we decided we were going to look at this and figure out there has to be a way. Like my father used to say, if you're going to do something, do your best, but if you can't, make it better. So we says, right, we'll sit down, we'll have a look at this and see if we can actually make this better. Let me see if any of these messages are for me, just in case. Okay, I can be heard. Okay, so what happened was, I sat down with a spreadsheet, okay, and I thought to myself, what is the what's the phenomenon that happens every single day in revenue share programs? If you can figure out what happens on a consistent basis, okay, then you can make something sustainable, right? Because the only thing that makes something just you know, not sustainable is once something stops. Every single day in revenue share, people buy advertising packs, okay? So I thought, well, what if we take the sales and focus on the sales, because that happens all the time. What can we do with those sales that can make the revenue share industry potentially more sustainable? And I thought, well, what's unsustainable? I thought, well, a linear matrix system is considered to also be unsustainable, because you end up running out of, you know, momentum. But then long story short, we thought, okay, let's put those sales into the linear system. And we were absolutely astounded with the result that we got. Okay. I had done the spreadsheet. I said something I probably shouldn't have said when I seen the results. I deleted it. I done it again. I thought it was a mistake. I deleted it. I done it again. I sent the spreadsheet to my partner in Australia. He said it's right. It can't lie. The spreadsheet can't lie. Everybody we've shown since has taken a little bit of time to get it, because up until this point, it's been a little bit hard to understand. They've all said the same thing when the penny dropped. Whoa. You know, just whoa. Okay. So here's what we've done. Today I'm going to take you through a bit of a mishmash of a presentation, because our main presentation is 30 slides long. You don't want to see that today. Okay. But what I will tell you is that we have created a platform that is unique, okay? Absolutely unique. And we are not a revenue share business. We have a lot of the traits of a revenue share business, but we are not one. You see, what we've created is an advertising platform where we wholesale, okay? We wholesale traffic and education credit packs to our network of distributors. Our distributors are people who buy our traffic at a wholesale price, okay, which is 50% off retail value, and they retail it online to customers. Now, our platform, unlike other platforms, doesn't talk anything about the income, you know, or the affiliate opportunity on the main website. Our affiliate opportunity is hidden, and distributor opportunity is in a different directory. So our distributors sell our products, our packs, and they take care of the affiliates, okay? We have an education library, okay, and we sell traffic. Now, our traffic is niche specific, so we sell traffic for internet marketers who can increase their Alexa rank, generate more leads, you know, and just help themselves get better and better online. Now, let me briefly show you, if I go to this slideshow, I'm just going to briefly show you this slide and how this slide is the backbone of the entire thing, okay? So let's move that over there. Here you can see you've got the network line, what we call the network line, and the power line, okay? Now, as a distributor, you can earn 10% on direct sales commission, okay, for every sale, wholesale sale made or purchased by one of your distributors, you'll receive 10%. If an affiliate makes a sale, we'll talk about that part later, okay, because that sometimes confuses people. But every time you spend $18 with us, okay, every time you spend $18 with us, we will give you, okay, 3 bonus units. So effectively, if you want to make that less, every time you spend $6 with us, we give you 1 bonus unit. But the minimum is an $18 wholesale purchase, okay? In the network line, if you are just someone who hasn't recruited any new distributors, you just want to make some sales, okay? Your 3 bonus units will go into the network line, okay, over here, just as you can see. This person is what's called non-power line qualified and has 3 units go into this line, all right? And if you're power line qualified, 2 units go into the power line, 1 unit goes into the network line. So what happens here is everybody is sending benefit to everybody, but obviously the team leaders are, you know, in the power line who can earn more because they are the ones building the network, okay? So this is what helped me solve that first problem of not everybody, you know, earns what they're worth on here. Everybody earns the same. But in Powerline, the leaders, everybody earns, you know, at different levels. and the leaders can absolutely earn more. Now, the entire system is built up on a very, very simple mathematical equation. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to exit out of the spreadsheet now, if my computer lets me, which it's not going to. There we go. And I'm going to bring up a simple little calculator. And this is how the maths went when we started doing this presentation, when we started working this out, okay? That's down here. Here we go. When I started doing this, I wanted to figure out how far can I make money go, you know? If you want to make something sustainable, then you need to make it go as far as you can. And the only problem that we had was making money go as far as it could. We need to make money stretch as far as possible to create the most sustainable program ever created. So I thought, okay, let me think here. What if I took $5 and what if I took $5? Okay, I'm going to turn Skype here on to Do Not Disturb, folks. Just one second. Okay. I'm back again. Sorry about that, guys. Okay, so I thought, what if I can... calculator. Where did it go? Here we go. Okay. How far can I make $5 go? Okay, so I thought, okay, well, there's 500 cents in $5. So what if I wanted to pay 1,000 people from that $5, 500 cents? So I divided that by 1,000 people. So I can pay 1,000 distributors half a cent. Obviously, half a cent's not a lot of money, right? But then if I pay even half a cent to 1,000 people, I pay it all out in one day. It's all gone in one day. So I thought, okay, let's divide that by 100 days. So I can pay 1,000 people, 1,000 distributors, 1,000 members, whatever you choose to call them, I can pay them 0.005 for 100 days. All right, I thought, brilliant. Okay, so that's a number that works, okay, for longevity. So I thought, okay, here's what's going to happen. We're going to take this and we're going to put it into a linear system and we're going to make everything work, okay? Now, what happened last night was I created this presentation. Now, this presentation that you're seeing today, you've been called here by Paul and some of the, you know, leaders out there in the online marketing world. And I promised Paul and Chris that I wouldn't go through the entire presentation because it's 30 slides long, okay? We want to make this quick and easy for you to all understand. The platform's phenomenal. The business is phenomenal. We are phenomenal because we're decent, normal, average, everyday people. We don't pretend to be something we're not. So I'm just going to cut to the chase and show you how this works from a distributor's point of view, okay? All the other information you need, we'll get to you on the website, okay? So here's how it works as a distributor for Traffic Powerline, okay? It's very, very simple. Traffic Powerline website, we sell views, okay? We provide views and education to online marketers entering the online world to help them excel online, and our education packages can help them in life also. Now, we sell our product via what's called credit packages, okay? These are credit packages here. Quite simply, each of our credit packs has 180 website view credits and 180 e-store credits. So when you purchase a pack, you can put your website on their system and get 180 website views, okay? And you can also buy some educational products in our online store. This is Bob. Let's say for argument's sake now that Bob is you. You're a distributor. You purchase our credit packs wholesale for $9 each, okay? Every time you spend $18 with us, we give you what's called bonus units, okay? So every time you purchase wholesale, we give you bonus units. Now, every time a website visitor purchases a credit pack at retail, which is $18 retail, okay, Bob gets 100% commission. Ignore this slide a little bit for now because I'm not here to try and explain the retail model. I'm here to explain the potential of this 4 years as a distributor, okay? So you buy retail, you buy wholesale, you sell retail, and if you have affiliates, the affiliates work for you. They don't work for us here at the company, okay? Now, here's what happens. This is you today, okay? Today, you're going to watch this presentation. You're going to be amazed, and you're going to want to become a TPL distributor, okay? So to do that, here's what you need to do. You need to go and buy our $54 minimum wholesale purchase starter pack, okay? And for every $18 that you spend with us, or for every six, we will give you a bonus unit, or for every 18, we'll give you three bonus units. And here's what we do with those bonus units. We don't give them to you, okay? Because they're a bonus. They're a bonus for being an active distributor. But we're going to take that bonus unit and we're going to put that into an income center for you, okay? This is your income center. An income center's hold units. Now, every single distributor who comes in on what's called the network line. And this is your network line. And this is your little piece of, you know, opportunity on the network line. And every single other distributor comes in and does the same. Now, Jill here, anybody who's yellow, has been introduced by you. Sam, on the other hand, was introduced by someone we don't even know. Okay, so was Mike, but then you introduced John. Okay, and John was introduced by you. John gets his unit on the network line, and Jack, again, is a person that's come from somewhere that we don't even know, you know, who the referrer was. Now, obviously, it's quite a small spreadsheet, so I can't show you on the spreadsheet, but back to that sum that we've done, where we can pay 1,000 people from $5, there are another 995 income centers in this line that count towards your income or your potential income, okay? So your potential income and traffic power line in the network line is made up from 1,000 of these income centers, okay? Now, here's what happens. Effectively, we give you what you could call an online piggy bank, okay? We call this your bonus line pool, okay, or your reserve. Here's what happens. Every single day, remember that calculation I said that, you know, I can divide $5 by 1,000 levels and pay 0.005? We already calculated that number just works, okay? So every single day, we take 0.005 from every single one of these active units in your network line. In this case here, for example, it would be 9 times 0.005 would go to your piggy bank or to your bonus pool, okay? And every one of these would be 9 times 0.005. But obviously, as people develop their networks and their businesses, the amount of bonus units in these income centers increases because every time you spend $6 with us wholesale, we give you a bonus unit. Now, the maximum you can hold in an income center in bonus units is 600 units, okay? So for the sake of this calculation, to show you the true power and potential of the traffic power line system, I'm going to do this calculation based on 1,000 maxed out income centers, okay? So if you've got 1,000 maxed out income centers at 600, 1,000 times 600 is 600,000, times that very simple calculation of 0.005 gives you $3,000, okay? So what we do is we take that $3,000 in revenue, we don't give it all to you, but we pay it into what you could call your online virtual piggy bank or your bonus pool, okay? Your line's bonus pool or reserve. Now, what happens from that bonus pool is this. We then pay your specific bonuses from that pool. And the first of those bonuses that we give you is called a personal volume bonus. Your personal volume bonus is based on the amount of units that you personally have in your income center. It's not based on your sales. It's not based on your recruitment. It's not based on anything other than the amount of bonus units you've managed to, you know, accumulate during your activity in the business, okay? The next one that we pay you is what's called a traffic contribution bonus. Now, we want to pay you to help us send traffic to our customers because you're the type of traffic that we need. You're an online, you know, entrepreneur, you're a distributor, you're actively online every day. So if you can help us deliver that type of traffic to our customers, you're the exact type of person that they're looking for, and we'll pay you a a traffic contribution bonus. Now, you don't have to surf sites, you don't have to look at them, but if you do, we'll pay you this bonus. We also pay you what's called a network line bonus. Now, remember, this is the network line. Everybody's units, okay, everybody has units that go into the network line as distributors, okay? Everybody has a portion of them that go in here. We also have a cashback bonus. Now, based on this example above, okay, on 1,000 levels contributing $3,000, you would get $29, which is 1% more or less. We have a consistency bonus that we pay to members as well, and we also have what's called a booster bonus, but you need to qualify for that as a distributor. Now, obviously, there's a section missing here at the end. I'm going to show you that in a minute. But your potential income is potentially $136 a day based on this example. Okay, now this is not a projection of income. It is not likely to be what's an average income. But today we're talking to distributors who are at the start of this business. But I can't tell you when this example is achieved, though. You know, 1,000 maxed out income centers, that will be the potential daily payment for someone in the network line, okay? Daily, you can multiply. There's quite a bit of revenue left over from that $3,000, okay? What we do with that is we distribute that across the rest of the network, but that's for another call. We've got leader pools, bonus pools. We've got Kickstarter fund that helps, you know, people with less money to get started in business. It's like a sponsorship fund. We've got lots of different funds that we, you know, have in the network, in the business, to support the members and their teams and things like that. But that's for another call, okay? So that's your potential revenue there. Everybody comes in on the network line. But when you reach 600 units, okay, in the network line, we will give you a brand new bonus unit at the end of the line in the next available position, not with 600 units in it now, but you can build again. We will start giving you more bonus units, and you can have as many of these income centers as you want, potentially paying you $136 per day as we move forward over the next number of years in this business, because this business has been created to be sustainable, okay? So, as a, you know, a serious network or someone who's out there building a team and, you know, focusing on, you know, their sales, their network growth, development, if you decide to introduce to us two referral distributors, two more distributors, then your credits also go into the power line, okay? And the power line is where things begin to happen, okay? Because your units will go into the power line. So on this example, I'm going to do the same thing, and I'm going to show you a power line example with everybody with 9 units, okay? The same example as the previous page. The line is exactly the same. The line has 1,000 positions on it, okay? And you also have in this line like a virtual piggy bank called your line's bonus pool, okay? Same thing again happens. Every single day from the power line, we take 0.005 from every unit. Every day members are purchasing, you know, more wholesale. We're giving away more bonus units to the network, and they all have to fall into these income centers. In the network line, the maximum amount of units that you can hold in an income center, okay, is 400. But it works exactly the same. So every single day, we take money, small, very small portions of money from the entire line, and we send it back to your bonus pool. So for this example, 400, okay, bonus centers, okay, or yeah, bonus units, times 0.005 times 1,000 levels comes to $2,000, okay? And the same thing happens again. That $2,000 goes into your online bonus pool. But here's the thing. You are now a network line member. You are responsible, or partially responsible, for helping us build this entire network, because you're qualified here because you brought two new distributors to the business, okay? Here's what happens. The very same income streams and bonus pools and bonus payments are paid to you. You get your personal volume bonus. You get your traffic bonus. But you also get a very, very attractive power line bonus, because in the network line, members are paid a 2% or a 1% power line bonus. But sorry, in the network line, they're paid a 1 or 2% network line bonus. But here in the power line, you're potentially paid up to $960 per income center that you have. And remember, I said you can have as many of these income centers as you wish, but every time you reach a maximum of 400, that income center falls, the new income center you have falls to the end. Okay? This is absolutely phenomenal. Okay? Because as activity to our advantage as a company, but we've made it more legitimate, more sustainable, more compliant, and we've created a really good concept here where everybody is sending benefit to everybody else moving through the business development. Okay? We've also got the cashback, we've got the consistency bonus as well, and we also again have the booster bonus. Again, there's a large portion of the revenue yet left, I'll show you that in a moment, but potentially that's $350 or $60 a day from the same activity you know, work line are doing, but you have helped to by introducing to the new. So we have created a system here that is not a revenue share model, because in revenue share program qualify for anything, okay? And revenue share and as much as you want as well. Now, one of the other things that you know got up my nose, okay, didn't sit well with me, was how someone with a large amount of money could I'm gonna put up a white background here just so for this presentation, okay? Now you can have big leaders out there in the industry who come in and try and spend 50 or 60,000 or 100,000 in revenue share programs. I've experienced it. I own a revenue share program. But this traffic power line is not a revenue share program because it's just totally different. The big spenders come in and they spend a lot of money on advertising packages because they're trying to manipulate the financial reward available in the system, okay? But what Traffic Powerline does, you know, as I showed you, it restricts you to how many you can have, how many bonus units you get per, you know, income center. So even if you came in with 50,000, here is what our system would do. Traffic Powerline does not allow you to buy any product, okay, until you know everybody else in our distributor base has had a chance to succeed, okay, and also it doesn't let you buy a product until the bonuses are available in the system. So here we'll look at your position in the network or the power line, and it will say, okay, this position has got 10 more positions after it, and each one of those positions have 400 units, okay? So it says this person's unit, okay, has 4,000 active units after it. So it takes that number and it multiplies it by the same number again, the 0.005, and it gives us 20, okay? Now we have in place what's called a 50% rule, because 50% of the revenue always has to go back to the different pools. So we divide that by 2, okay, and that gives us 10. And we then divide that, okay, by either 0.0275 or 0.0003, okay. But what it gives us is the amount of money that we can pay you on a daily basis for the next 100 days, okay. So let's take the power line as an example. And it tells us 166, okay. This means that you can have 166 bonus units maximum. Now this allows every other distributor a chance to be able to sell their bonus units or to sell their product and you know run their businesses, and it slows you know down the entire platform as far as big spenders coming in and manipulating it. Okay, that's the problem with online advertising platforms. People come on and they manipulate them. But with us, I don't mind who comes onto our platform as long as they buy my stock at wholesale, okay? Because they cannot buy unless I tell them they can. And my system tells them every single day how much they can buy. So you can come on and buy as much stock as you like, get as many of these bonus units as you like, but every time you try and buy, the system will say, okay, you've got four, how much units do you have after you? Okay, times 0.005 divided by 2, okay, divided by the bonus amount on that level. For this sake, I'm going to divide it by 6, okay? Equals. That's wrong. But you get where I'm going, okay? It's 10, it was 10 divided by 10, bear with me folks, I will get it right. 10 divided by 0.005. Okay? Now, you can buy, that calculation was wrong as well. 10 divided by 0.005. Okay, I'm not saying that's right, but that doesn't look right to me. So, you can't buy any more packs or, you know, spend any more money any faster than our system tells you that you can, okay? That's my phone ringing. I wonder if somebody sent me a message on Skype. No, everything seems to be working fine. That's good. I'll ignore the phone. So, folks, that's what we've got, okay? Now, that's the most shortest presentation I've been able to make so far. But when you actually sit down and go through this again with yourself, you'll understand that this entire system can pay you for 1,000 levels. It's not rev share. This is not rev share at all. This is based on a formula, okay? This is based on me paying you on 1,000 levels of activity in your network. This is based on real sales. It's based on a wholesale retail distributor model, okay? This is not revenue share, but what we've done is we've taken the phenomenon of what happens in revenue share programs and we've adjusted it into our business, our platform. It's the most, if you wanted to call this a revenue share, which some of you probably will, but I don't believe it is because there's too many qualifications in there, this is the most powerful revenue sharing platform ever created. But I would prefer it if people didn't call it a revenue share. I would like it if you called it the revenue share adjustment or the revenue share fix, because we've created something that is absolutely phenomenal here. You cannot manipulate our system. If you come into our system and try and manipulate it, you know, to the detriment of the other members, fine. But you're not going to be able to, because we're going to tell you how many packs you can buy. We're going to only allow you to have 400 or 600 units, bonus units in each line. So if you have another income center, your unit will go to the end of the line and the whole system sends benefit to everybody else in the system. Now, I'm not going to show you, I am going to show you very, very briefly, okay? This is a spreadsheet here. Look how many columns are on the spreadsheet. Look how many numbers are on this spreadsheet, okay? Now, I'm not going to take you through this today because it becomes confusing. But you've been invited here by Paul today. And as Paul said, we spent hours on a call because Paul wanted every tiny little bit of detail about this plan, okay? It works, okay? It absolutely works. And what we do is we just calculate all the units in the network and the power line after years so that, you know, it calculates how much of the revenue within the network is being distributed to you. The numbers cannot lie, okay? You all know that you have a car outside your home, okay? If you're very, very wealthy, you might have a car inside your home, okay? But everybody knows how a car works. You put fuel in that car, you get in, and you make it drive. But not everybody's a mechanic, okay? Well, Paul wanted to be the mechanic and understand exactly how this vehicle worked. But I can tell you that the fuel for this vehicle is this, $5, okay, divided by 1,000 levels of income equals 0.005, okay, divided over 100 days for sustainability of our reward program gives you, I got it wrong, okay, 500 it was, sorry, okay, divided by 1,000 levels, which is 500 cents, divided by 100 is 0.005. The fuel for this car, or this vehicle, is that number. The entire system works on that figure of 0.005 down 1,000 levels. You can have as little or as many bonus units as you want, but you can't manipulate our system. But if the big people want to come on and try and manipulate it, then we've already fixed it to make sure it's sure that it's of benefit to absolutely everybody. Now, I'm going to leave you with this slide. I'm going to hand back to Paul, and hopefully I've impressed you. But today we tried to reduce this way down. It's the best presentation we've managed to come up with so far. As we progress through the business, other, you know, leaders will come with new ideas to show us how to simplify this presentation more. But what you've got is you've got two tracks, okay? In other revenue share businesses, like, I don't want to call this that because it's not, but, you know, in revenue share businesses online, you've got everybody, it's unbalanced, okay? Everybody's riding down one track. But here, we've got the power line. So you can place the train on the two tracks and remain steady the whole way through. It's a very, 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 very powerful system. And it's just based on 0.005. So thanks very much for listening, folks. I'll hand you back to Paul. And hopefully, Paul's going to tell me that that was easy to understand, or I'll be on the PowerPoint presentation and spreadsheets again tonight.
No, I tell you, Pierce, very good, very good. You got that into a half an hour, so that was fantastic. Because by the time you started, before you went on the end, so that's brilliant, and it was recorded. Guys, and just so you understand one thing, we've all been working online for a few years now, and a lot of us on this call are very, very, very big leaders, okay? It's a leader's call. And I want you to understand something here. Like, if you go through the multi-level marketing arena, and look what the RevShare business done, how sophisticated it has got in the past few years to when it started 5 years ago. And as companies progress, they're getting more sophisticated and better at what they do. Now, Pierce has turned it on its head and done it a different way altogether. He's proved there on a mathematical formula that he can sustain the revenue share fix, as Pierce calls it, okay? Now, what I want you to understand is this. All businesses out there, okay, people complain about one thing. When they join a business, I want to join with you. I want to get right next to you at the top. I want to get spillover. I can't recruit people. Well, guys, this is one team. If you don't recruit nobody, you're in the network line. And everyone that falls in below you, okay, you're going to get paid. If you go and bring in two people, you're in the power line then as well. And every single person that comes in below you, everybody has to fill the line. There is no other line. It's just straight down after each other. And you get paid down 1,000 levels. Do you understand the power of this? It's a team build. Everybody is building for everybody. Yes, of course, the guy who recommends more people is going to make more money because there's built-in restrictions. But what it means is we have a system where every single person is going to get paid and get paid on the rewards of his whole team. I haven't ever seen this kind of structure before. It's the first I've seen it. And it's the first I've seen a mathematical formula like this as well. So guys, this is going to be huge, you know. And obviously, it's up to you to make a decision what is for you. It's 2 weeks away from being launched. And we're so lucky to have Chris who sponsors me, Chris Cronin, into the business. We're so lucky to have Chris works hand in hand with Pierce. And for the next 2 weeks, Pierce has given us the offer to help us to pre-build before the launch. So guys, in the next month or 2 months, you won't get a hold of Pierce because he'll be so busy. So we can take the advantage now for the next 2 weeks, and Pierce is doing these calls with me nearly every day now. So if you want this call to happen again over the weekend, we say our Monday, Tuesday, just get on to me and we can make it happen, okay? So with that, I was going to see, is there anyone, any questions, guys? Please put them in the box and we can answer them. But I think Pierce has done a fine job in answering nearly everything there. If it's your first time, guys, seeing it, yes, I understand you might not get it all on the first time, but it is recorded, so go over the recording and you can get more familiar with it. No, what does the company fills the gap? Yeah, well, yeah, okay. As well, guys, remember this. And at the end of each day, there's the company have so much fun. So what they do at the end of each day, they calculate and they buy more units as well. Okay, can one person have multiple accounts? Pierce, I leave you answer that one. Can one person have multiple IDs?
Okay, the only multiple accounts that a distributor can have is a customer account and a distributor account. This system is a straight line team effort, okay, as Paul said. So when doing the maths and the calculations, when we took the other thing about what's revenue sharing businesses, about stacking accounts, that makes this system fall down a little bit, okay? So there is only one distributor account allowed per IP address, okay? One distributor account per IP and one customer account per IP, okay? Unfortunately, you can't have multiple accounts because you don't need them because we give you multiple income centers. So you don't need multiple accounts. One account, is all that's allowed per IP on.
Yeah, and guys, just so you understand what Pierce is saying there, okay? Because when you hear it first, it might come across, you might not understand. Like, you can have one account per household, but this design, you can have multiple income centers. This is what it means, guys. If you have one income center under, let's say your name is Chris, for example, of, and he've address, let's say whatever his address is, okay? So that's he've one position, but Chris starts off, let's say, with 400 units in there, right? Which is $2,000. Chris can have multiple income centers, so multiple positions of 400. Okay, it's like the same as multiple accounts, but it's not multiple accounts. Okay, I don't want to be confusing people. Okay, so you can have one position, but under that position, you can have multiple accounts. And watch this, guys. If you start off, let's say, on level four, and let's say you start off with 400 packs. Okay, if you want another income center, you might have to go down to level 100. So what are you doing? You're going underneath your team. So you are actually supporting your team, and then when they want another one, they're going under you. So everybody is supporting everybody. So you can have ma as many income centers as you want. So can you imagine what Pierce just showed you? Pierce showed you the potential of one income center on the power line and on the network line. But remember, guys, you can have multiple income centers. So look at the power of the money now. Unbelievable. Oh, another question here. Are the payment processors going to increase other than Bitcoin and the Tether, as the US Canada market can't accept the Tether? Pierce, that's for you.
Yeah, okay. The payment processors are not going to change. They're going to stay as they are. Bitcoin is a currency without borders, okay? There is, nobody can say that Bitcoin is a currency with borders. All the other payment processors, Pay, for example, Payeer, OKPay, Perfect Money, okay? That's the main one, okay? What else is there? OKPay, and there's another one. They can all send Bitcoin, every one of them. I logged into Payeer just a couple of days ago to check. There's money in my Payeer account. I logged in and I clicked on send Bitcoin, and it sent Bitcoin out for me. But we're going to do a tutorial video, a little short tutorial video to show members how to use the other payment processors. But OKPay, Payeer, and Payza, and the main ones, STP included, you can send out Bitcoin. Okay? We're not going to change the payment processors because these are the two most sustainable and secure for our members. If we have a large portion of members asking for a specific one, we may consider introducing it because obviously we don't want to stunt the development of the business. I don't want to put in more. I think two is plenty because all the others can send Bitcoin. But we are willing to work with and listen to the network and do what we can to help everybody progress.
Yeah.
So it's not a final answer, okay?
Yeah, so then what you're saying, so Pierce, let's say if someone had Payeza, which is a popular one, because Payeza, you can send Bitcoin out through Payeza, somebody can use that method.
That's correct, yeah.
So guys, so basically, like, you look at even PayPal are getting into the Bitcoin space now. So most of the processors are heading towards Bitcoin, so we'll be able to use all of them, okay? Most of them. Another question, Pierce. Okay. I want to make sure people understand this question now. In
Okay.
the power line, you can have up to 400 positions, okay, yeah?
400 units in a
building. Units, yeah, units. And in the networking, you can have 600, okay? So the question is this, when somebody reaches 400 in the power line, and but they haven't reached 600 in the network line, can they open another income center?
Yes.
The question was, do they have to max the 400 and the 600 before they open another income center?
The lines are independent of each other. They grow at an independent rate, okay? You're not linked to the one income center, and one line is not linked to an income center and another line. It's not. They're independent. You could potentially have four income centers in one line and only one income center in the other. It just depends at which rate each of the lines grow. Obviously, the power line is going to grow quicker than the network line.
Yeah, because it's 2-to-1 ratio. Yeah, that's great. No, because two people asked that question. Another question here is, I suppose this might be for support. I cannot log in. I registered, but cannot log in. So I registered again, but still cannot log in.
Clear your cache. Clear your cache in your computer. We had a login cookie issue yesterday. Yesterday we were updating the website. Try clearing your cache and clearing your history. 2 minutes after this call, I'll speak to the development team. I done that last night. When I cleared my cache, it worked again then. So try clearing cache and history. And once that's done, you'll be able to log in. But I guarantee you, straight after this call, I'm going to go and talk to the development team and double check that there's no problems with the site. Guys, we are in pre-launch. There is a lot of work going on in the background, okay? Yesterday we introduced a new member invite feature, which I suggested you use if you're out and about on your mobiles and stuff. You can send emails directly to people that you know directly from the back office. But I'll check straight after this call, you have my word, and I'll get that fixed as soon as possible.
What's the date for launch? Another question.
I should know that, shouldn't I? I don't know. As soon as we're ready.
Yeah, but can you give an estimate? An estimate date, roughly?
2 weeks. Well, what's today's date?
The 12th.
It'll be about 11 days from now.
That's the 27th, which is a Saturday. So it'll be before the end of the month.
Mm-hmm.
And so it'll be launched before the 1st of September. Yeah, that'd be good. It'd be safe to say that. That's 2.5 weeks.
Easy.
Okay, guys, so you have that, guys. So no, guys, it's about pre-building. So so when the launch day goes live. Okay, and another question, Pierce, just came in there, actually. When it goes live, let's say if somebody sponsored 10 people, okay, and everybody is a free member, what happens if one of his members registers before him? Does the system still recognize that your genealogy is kept in place?
Your genealogy, everybody's put into the system by date stamp, by date of registration, okay?
Okay.
And
but what happens, right? Because this happened before in another company, what it did, right? They were launching a new division of the company, okay? So what they said, when everybody pays, because sometimes if it goes live, let's say if Chris sponsored me, I might pay before Chris, so my invoice is in before Chris, even though Chris is my sponsor, so Chris might lose commissions. So what this company did, they gave everybody a week. They paid out no commissions for the first week. They gave everybody 1 week to get registered. Then they ran the commissions. So then who's ever upgraded, the commissions would go directly to the sponsor or the people in place.
Okay, well, that's exactly what's going to happen here. It's called a transition period.
Exactly.
As soon as we open the doors, we're going to have an influx of new business, and everybody will be put into the system on their date stamp, but they will also be given a transition period to give them a period of time to buy their wholesale pack and get started. So, yes, the exact same will happen here. Nobody will miss out because they paid after their sponsor or something like that.
Okay, another question here now. Some good questions, guys, so keep them coming. This is the place to get them. Okay, how can we be trained on the presentation and slides? Ranuk, get on to, I think it was Yanin, after the call, and arrange another private call. Anyone on this call, guys, can arrange another private call, because we can't get Pierce, obviously, all day. And I can go over now and do a training. I'm after seeing this a good few times, and I can do an in-depth training with anybody, okay?
We're going to make that short presentation on the, I'm not sure if it's on my screen being shared at all, I don't know. But that presentation, hang on a second, leave the webinar. Can you still hear me, yeah?
Yeah.
So I didn't really kick myself off the webinar. That presentation with the slides that I've done, I'm going to make that available when it's done as a training. I'm going to end that slide.
Yeah, that'd be very, very good.
This one here, let me just go back. I'm going to make this available to everybody so that they can use it. Which one is it? It's here somewhere, I know it is. This one here, okay?
Mm-hmm.
This one allows you to show members exactly how the whole process works, okay? Every distributor gets bonus units in an income center on the line, and it shows the exact calculations. A very short little presentation. Obviously, I'm rallying through it here. But this shows exactly how it works, and we'll make this available to all the leaders, but I'm going to make sure that it's compliant before we do, and every leader will have their own copy, okay? So that's how you can use it for trainings, but obviously you'll need trained on it first, okay?
Okay, this question's come up, and see, every question comes up, guys. We'll put everything in. Is this business part of Mobrapis?
It is part of Mobrapis company. It is. It's under the Mobrapis umbrella. Mobrapis Limited, Mobrapis UK Limited, own Traffic Powerline. It's the same company that own it, but it's an absolutely independent platform. Totally different business model, totally different platform, but it's just owned by the same company. And you can take confidence in that, because if you do some research online about myself, about Mobrapis, we pride ourselves in being, you know, normal, average, everyday people who are just trying to make a difference in the online world. We're trusted and respected by our members for being honest, ethical, and transparent. But the answer is yes, it's under the same umbrella company.
Okay, that's great. And guys, another thing as well, which I think is very good as well, to add to that, this is under the UK law. Piers, correct me if I'm saying anything wrong. And also, guys, when you join the business under the UK law, there's a two-week refund policy. So if you're not happy in 2 weeks, there's a full refund available for you.
Absolutely. In the first 7 days, we follow UK law. We follow UK legislation. We want to be 100% compliant in everything that we do. So for the first 7 days, a distributor cannot spend more than £200 or around $250 with us. And for the first 14 days, you have the right to your full money back in the first 14 days. They are UK laws that we will stand by, and everybody gets a full 14-day money back guarantee.
Yeah, the next question is just, I think we just answered that there. We call it anyway. Is it registered in the UK? The answer is yes.
The UK, it is incorporated in the UK. Mobrapis Limited was incorporated on the 12th of March 2015. Everything is up to date. Our tax returns, everything is up to date. The company is what's called in good standing with Companies House. It's, you know, it's a solid company, and everything's, you know, registered.
Next thing come in here, is it a 14-day commission waiting period?
Somebody's on the ball. Yeah, it is. What happens is, it's not a waiting period, okay? It's a delay. What will show in your back office is you will be shown your commissions, but it will show as pending. And until that affiliate has passed the 14-day threshold, then those commissions will not be released into what's called your wallet. But after a member has been a member for 14 days, it will fall into your wallet, and you will get all of those commissions. So you might have, you know, 10 members, 10 distributors register in your business today, and they get to work at 14 days activity, and in 14 days time, that revenue will be released to you, and the commissions will be released to you in 14 days. But it's only from individual members, okay? What happens is, anyway, it doesn't really matter, is because the only reason we do that as a company is that so we can monitor who is staying with us as distributors and who is deciding to leave. And the people who decide to leave are the positions that we take over as the company. Now, what Paul also said at the start was, if you look here on this presentation, if I go to this very last slide, you'll see a part that says surplus, okay? Now, this is something we didn't show. Every day, we take 20%, okay, from the network line surplus, and we buy packs in the company to support the distribution team. We buy more bonus units. We place bonus units into the system, to help the system progress and remain sustainable. And we do that in both lines. We take 20% from we take 30% from the network line and we buy units, we place units into the power line, and we take 20% from the power line and we place units into the network line. So what we also do with this revenue is when a member drops out, if a distributor wants a refund, they don't like the business after 14 days, we as a company take over that gap in the system so that there are no gaps in the system whatsoever. But yes, there is a slight delay on commissions, but not for you. It's just so we can track it as a company, so we can know what positions we need to take over. It's like a takeover policy.
And next question is that, but it, like, is it correct in saying that every single commission we make is paid 14 days later? So the question then is, after 14 days, then do we get paid every day if we do a withdrawal?
Every single day you'll get paid. You get paid every day. You will see these commissions coming every day. They'll show us pending in your back office. We haven't actually put a final decision in place on that, but as a company, because of the 14-day refund policy, we have to protect ourselves financially.
Yes.
So you will show your commissions, you will see your commissions, you will see what's coming towards you, okay? After 14 days, you are locked in as a member, okay? Your refund policy has expired, and then you will be able to withdraw money every day as well, okay? It just gives everybody the legal opportunity, and it makes the business compliant and it makes it fair for everybody. Yeah. Once you're on 14 days, you can withdraw your revenue, your commissions, your money, and everything else. Everything will run as normal after 14 days. But up until 14 days, you're going to be, you know, locked into the, you're a potential liability to the company for 14 days. And you're a potential liability to all the distributors for 14 days. Because if you take a refund out, then, you know, you've left a financial hole in the system, so to speak, okay, in the reward program. So after 14 days, you're good to go, okay? So in those 14 days, just build your business, build your network, build your teams, and after 14 days, you're off and running.
Yeah, I think as well, guys, that gives comfort to everybody. So if you bring somebody in, you tell them on the very first day, you have 14 days to make up your mind. So if it's not for you, avail of the refund. So it brings a lot of credibility to the company. Next question. Can we have a limited company account as well as a personal account? Good question.
Well, what can I say? A limited company is a legal entity in its own right. You know, companies are allowed to advertise. There are limited companies out there who want to use our advertising services. So legally, I can't really say no.
Yeah, but what Absolutely. We do, guys, as leaders, though, I think Piers can answer that one. Believe me, answer that one, please. Because as being from the field, okay, what we don't want, guys, is stacking. There's enough in here for everybody, okay? So I have five or six companies, and I could, and let's say Chris sponsored me, I could be very clever and start stacking and block commissions from Chris, okay? So we all know what stacking is, okay? So if you have one account per household, okay, one account per household, for me personally, and this is, I just give my personal opinion, what I'm going to do, one account per household, whether it's a company or yourself, and then you can have multiple income centers. But if you start, let's say, bring yourself in, your company, this person, then the company below, you know, that's called stacking. Even though legally the company can't do nothing, but it's called stacking. So for true the fair play and for your team and for all of us, if we all go down the one way, I think there's enough in it for everybody. That's my just personal.
But also, just to expand on that a little bit, stacking creates a pattern, okay? I don't care if a member, now this is probably going to sound a little bit harsh, okay? But anybody who knows me knows that I consider my job to be to protect the member's best interests all the time. I focus on members' interests all the time because it's the members that build my business, you know. So if I see a pattern emerging in an account or in a team, you know, and I even think that it's stacking, it creates a pattern. It's not just about the IP addresses and the accounts, okay? Like, for example, if I refer 10 distributors, okay, and only one of those distributors to the referrer on a daily basis, then it's obvious that there's stacking taking place deliberate, okay? So if it becomes clear that it's absolutely deliberate what is being done, just to take that extra 10% in sales commission, then those accounts will be removed from the system, okay? Stacking will not be tolerated here because it's theft. Technically theft from the person who's done the hard work to bring you in as a distributor into the business. But with a limited company, I can't do anything about that, you know, because companies are allowed to advertise as well, and that's what we provide. We provide advertising. So.
Yeah, okay, guys, that's great. So, okay, guys, so listen, we're on the hour, just gone over the hour. So, listen, I want to thank Chris for introducing me to Pierce and to Traffic Powerline. I want to thank Pierce for his time for the past few days. And I think, guys, we're in a very good position here, very honest and down-to-earth owner, and with a track record with a company that's going very successfully since early 2015. So, guys, we've seen the formula, we've seen the maths, we've seen the system. So now it's up to each and every person on the call to decide if it's for them or not. So, guys, what we can do from here, we're going to end the call. There's loads of messages coming in my WhatsApp and my team looking to talk to me. After the call, send me a message on WhatsApp or get on to the person who recommended you to the call, and I will make the link available to everybody. So with that, guys, thanks, Pierce, thanks, Chris, and thanks to everybody for giving us the time early in the morning. Have a lovely day. Take care.
Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.